What's going on YouTube? It's Watchtone again, back with more Pew. When this guy by the name of Legendary Lucario 14 asked me for a battle, unlike the last time, I decided not to mess about and bring a team that I'm confident with. It turned out it was a bit too serious though, but without more spoilers, let's get into it. I lead with Stunfisk to set up my Stealth Rock right away, because it will take 25% from two major threats, Liveni and the Rotom, each time they switch in, and he doesn't have a rapid spinner. Meanwhile, he leads off with castrated Bugs Bunny, but I've got to give him some credits, at least he knows the difference between a bunny and a beaver, unlike some other guy, I completely forgot his name. Anyway, he protects, giving me a free turn to set up my rocks, which is very nice of him, so in return, I regain his Seismitoad's HP on the switch of a Scald. Unfortunately, he sees my true intentions of burning his Lopunny, decides to forget the kindness and takes me out with an Earthquake, which turned out to be a critical hit, but he told me afterwards he was banded, so I don't think it mattered. Anyway, now I go to and set up a substitute on a switch to Liveni. He breaks it with X-Scissor, but after a Stealth Rock damage, Sucker Punch and his own Life Orb recoil, he won't be able to survive another switch-in, so he just stays in and goes down to another Sucker Punch. Now he goes to Banette, but I know that the only reason he will do that is if he has a Will-O-Wisp, so I set up another sub to prevent that. Now I don't think he can do much to me other than that, so I go for a safe Seed Bomb, hit his Rotom on the switch, and then finish it with another Sucker Punch before it even breaks my substitute. In comes Rampardos, and surprisingly he isn't Choice Scarfed, so I outspeed him even without priority, and Seed Bomb turns out to be a one-hit KO. Then he goes back to his Lopunny, and I decide to let him break my substitute and use that turn to set up a Sword Stance. He U-turns back to Banette, but with his poor defenses, I don't think he will be able to survive a plus 2 Seed Bomb, and he indeed bites the dust as well. Plus 2 Sucker Punch finishes off a Lopunny, and Seed Bomb absolutely annihilates his Seismitoad. And that is the game. But wait, you didn't think I would end the video right there, did you? Right after this battle, he asked me for a rematch, so we had another one right away, and here it is. As you can see, I switched up my team entirely, even though on the previous match I used only 2 pokes, whereas he made only 1 change on his team and replaced Rotom Frost with an Ursa Ring. Let's get going. I lead with Shellgun, thinking that his Lopunny won't do much to me, so I can set up a Dragon Dance and wear his team down right from the start. He goes for an Attract, which isn't used competitively at all, but I think he just wanted a realistic moveset, and when you think about it, Lopunny is one of the best Pokemon to use it, and in the anime it would probably be very effective. Anyway, it sure is effective on my Barrel Roll, as it makes me unable to move, but knowing that he will just U-turn out of there and Attract effects will be removed, I set up a Dragon Dance as he goes to Seismitoad. Then I hit him with Outrage, which at plus 1 is an easy to hit KO, whereas his Ice Punch does only about half and he decides to leave this thing to die. Banette also takes a massive amount from it, but is just able to survive and go for a Will-O-Wisp. But he doesn't know yet that I'm a mono attacker with a Rest and a Sleep Talk, and all I need is to break through Confusion and get the rest off. I hit myself as he goes for a Sucker Punch, and the burn damage takes me down to only 50 HP, but even then, Shadow Sneak fails to take me out, I snap out of the confusion and recover from just 10 HP all the way up to full. Then he tries going for a Sucker Punch, but it fails against a Sleep Talk and I set up another Dragon Dance. For some reason he still stays in and hits me with a Shadow Sneak, but it does barely anything, so now he finally realizes that it's not a good matchup for him, and gets a free switch to Ursa Ring, his most powerful attacker, as I go for one too many Sleep Talk. Then I go for another Outrage, which at plus 2 will 2-hit KO anything on his team, but in exchange I take a Guts Boosted Facade and it does a fuckload of damage. He knows though that at plus 2 I easily outspeed him, so he decides to save his Winnie the Pooh and sends out a Bugs Bunny to take another Outrage instead. Then he makes a good play and protects against an Outrage, so I get confused again. I don't hit myself this time though, outspeed him and once again rest all the way up, and looking at the pitiful amount return did to me, I will be able to take it anyway. Now he protects again, I don't see the reason for it other than making this battle one turn longer. Then he goes for Attract again, but seeing that return is over 9000 hit KO, he gives up the idea of Attract and Confusion combo and switches out. Seeing that he's struggling to take me on, I set up another Dragon Dance on his switch, so that my Aldrich would actually one-hit KO most of his things, as seen right now against Rampardos. Now he goes back to Lopunny just to protect and confuse my Shelgon again, and then switches to Liveny as I get up to plus 4 with yet another Dragon Dance. But then Hag's Guts punish me for my greediness, I hit myself in confusion and he finally takes me out with a critical hit X Scissor, which definitely mattered, but I am actually glad he got it because at least it made the battle a bit more interesting. So now I'm able to show off my other pokes, and I decide to bring in Larvesta, knowing that he won't stay in, allowing me to boost my speed with a Flame Charge on the switch. He goes back to Lopunny and protects again just to scout, but then easily goes down to a Flare Blitz, and by the amount of recoil I took just from this one attack, I think you get my Larvesta's name. He brings his Banette, and at this point, I completely stopped thinking, knowing that I've got this game in the bag, so even though Sucker Punch is very obvious, I stay in and let him take me out. I bring my Shadow 2.0 now, take another Sucker Punch like a beast and finish him with a Brave Bird. He goes back to Liveny, thinking that he can revenge kill me, but what he doesn't know about is that this Ruffet is actually Scarf Hustle All Out Attacker, so he gets completely wrecked by another Brave Bird. Ursaring turns out to be his last Pokemon, and knowing that he is Guts and not a Quick Feed variant, I can bring pretty much any of my remaining Pokemon to finish the job, but I decided to let my Choice Bandit Sequin get the final kill, because have you ever seen this thing used competitively? Well, now you did, as Waterfall takes his Ursaring out, and that is the second game. Good games, Legendary Lucario. A bit one-sided, but as I said many times by now, that's PU and you never know what's gonna happen by looking at the teams, a point that I will prove many more times in the upcoming battles. As always, don't forget to leave a like or comment if you enjoyed, and I see you all next time.